Hey, we're back. In this episode, we're going to be finishing up the foundation by doing the stem walls, finishing up the sleeves, and then doing the threaded rods and J bolts. So let's get into it. So it's a bit cold today, so yeah, definitely winter is coming, and we might actually even get some snow later today, so hopefully not. Let's see. But as you can see, the crew has begun work. They've been working for a couple days, so they're currently on lunch. They've laid out the forms for the exterior walls of the stem walls, the foundation. So the general process that will be followed will be lay out all the exterior forms for the stem walls, followed by laying out the rebar. Then Marcel and I will come in and lay out all the sleeves for the drainage, water, electrical, French drains, radon, whatever. After that, we'll get the engineer, followed by the city inspector. Then the crew will lay out the other side of the stem wall forms, and that's such that the engineer and the city are able to easily see the work on the rebar and stuff. And then we will be doing the pouring of the concrete, so let's see. That's the plan, at least.
Morning, I'm in my favorite Halloween pajamas, and what we're going to do today is buy the sleeves for the concrete walls of the house. So the first thing we did was a list of all the sleeves that we have, along with the sizes and the widths of the walls, and we'll be heading to the home center in a moment. See you there! So here we are at the home center. We purchased the sleeves for our pipes. It's important to note when you have sleeves, they need to be at least one pipe size larger than what you're going to have inside. So our drain is 4 inch, so for instance this one is a 6 inch pipe, and then we have a 1 inch pipe in here. And now I'm going to show you how to cut the pipe. So this is how I like to cut pipe. The first step is obviously measuring, and then I just put marks at the right distance. Then the next step is I use regular masking tape and I draw a straight line. And what I do is I cover these dots with the masking tape, so it gives me a path of where I need to cut. Third step is I use my manual saw and I cut pretty much on top of the black line. And what I'm doing is I'm replacing the black line with a groove. So when I come to step 4 and I come with the saw, it already has somewhere to go and it's so much easier to cut straight. Once the pipe is cut, it's time to clean it up. So I have my deborder. It has a blade that creates a 15 degree bevel, which is ideal for plumbing. This one is good for pipes up to 4 inches. And the way it works is you just put it on the pipe and there it goes. And then you just spin it around. And it's going to clear any imperfections and create the bevel that I mentioned. The other deborder that I use is this one. This is for the inside of the pipe, and you just go around it like this, and same thing, smooths any imperfections that you may have. I also like to use this one on top of the pipe. I found that it's good to do 2 rounds, so you get the smoothest finish. Thank you.
I had one of those crazy weeks. I don't know if you guys know that I'm an engineer and I work in the corporate world, but I had a deliverable for yesterday, and it absolutely had to be finished by yesterday, otherwise the world would stop spinning and the sun would stop shining. And so that's the corporate world. Well, in March, we thought we were about to begin construction, and we literally drove all around Denver to try to find these threaded rods because they weren't available nearby. So that was March. We're in October now, and we still haven't used them. So yeah, you can tell where we come from, I guess. In the Look Ahead episode, I briefly discussed how we were planning to place the J-bolts and the threaded rods on the foundation at pour time. I know the engineer has discouraged us from doing that, and that was, I think, mostly because we may not be able to place them correctly. But as you saw on the Look Ahead episode, I know precisely where they need to go. So part of this effort, what I'm doing is on the J-bolts, I'm placing a little tape that's very bright so that I can easily tell the height. So if I don't see yellow, it means it's too deep. If I see exposure under the yellow, it means it's too shallow. We will be placing particular attention to the threaded rods because they actually connect to studs on the framing. Similarly, we have a 14-inch embedment versus a 10-inch exposure. Episode, I briefly discussed how we were going to do the bracing for the non-continuous stepped footing. So here it is. So the way we're going to be giving strength to this stem walls is by running a horizontal rebar, as you can see, and then we also run the 45 degree rebar, and that's how we get the strength that we need.
The crew has completed the metal work for the concrete forms and we are ready for inspection. What we are going to do today is mark the locations of the J-bolts and the threaded bolts. We have two different colors and I have prepared these templates. So I have marked the exact locations of the threaded rods and the J-bolts, and we have one of these for every single wall. Now, this added some effort to this phase, but it's going to make our life easier during framing. He also gave us an engineering letter that we submitted for the city, and they gave us the approval for the inspection. So now the crew is buttoning up so we can have concrete day. Let's mention this rigid insulation you see right here. It is here because we need to create a ledge for the concrete slab. Now, what we want to show you is these templates were a total success. So what this saves us is the effort of having to drill holes to insert all the J-bolts and threaded bolts. Here we have marked every location. It's pretty accurate. We put it along the wall and we did the marks. It saves us like effort, and it's also much safer than being on a 14-foot wall up the stairs with a measuring tape. So
this effort actually took some 20 hours worth of work. And I was talking to the subcontractor, and he mentioned that to drill each individual bolt takes up to 30 minutes. And you need a diamond bit, and sometimes if you hit rebar, they may get melted. So you have the cost of the bits, the cost of labor, the cost of the additional epoxy that may take up to 28 days to fully cure and not be usable until then. So imagine 30 minutes times 130 rods that we have, that would be about 65 hours worth of work versus 20 hours worth of work. At last, the day has arrived. Check out the size of that crane. That means we're pouring concrete today. We're going to be pouring 60 cubic yards of it, and that'll be about 6 trucks.
It took about 2 months to get the whole thing complete, but we're extremely happy with the results. The crew was amazing. Every single specification we gave them, they met it. And they also did a great job in cleaning up afterwards. Like, all these walls had some hooks coming out that were holding the forms. They came back and they removed every single one of them. And then they also went with a rebar on the top of the wall, and they just scrape it, so it's going to be nice, flat, and smooth when framing time comes.
I should probably mention that the foundation itself is most likely the biggest single ticket item of the entire house. We would actually probably say that we may be somewhere between 40 to 50% financially in the project just by having the foundation. So this was a tremendously large milestone. There's still some big ticket items coming up that will be like windows, framing, and all that kind of stuff. But once those smaller ticket items that continue to be big are taken care of, life should get significantly easier for us, at least.
At least financially.
At least financially, yes. Not work-wise, probably.
Yeah.
So what's next for us is we're in the middle of November. Winter is like knocking on the door, and we gotta hurry so that we can get our inspection for the plumbing. We are doing the waterproofing, insulation.
French drains.
So we gotta take. We're trying to get that all done right before Thanksgiving, hopefully. And you will see all of that on the next episode. So, yeah, that's where we're at. We'll see you in the next one, I guess.
Yeah, we're done with this episode. Please consider liking and subscribing our videos. It will help us grow our channel. And yeah, we'll see you on the next one. Bye.